North Korea fires ballistic missile into waters off Japan. North Korea has fired at least one ballistic missile into waters off the coast of Japan, South Korea and Japan's militaries have said. It comes as South Korea, Japan and U.S. intelligence chiefs reportedly meet in Seoul to discuss North Korea. In recent weeks, Pyongyang has embarked on a flurry of tests of what it claims to be hypersonic and long-range cruise missiles, and anti-aircraft weapons. Some of these tests violate strict international sanctions. North Korea is specifically prohibited by the United Nations from testing ballistic missiles as well as nuclear weapons. On Tuesday, South Korea's Joint Chiefs of Staff said one missile was launched from the port of Sinpo, in the east of North Korea where Pyongyang usually bases its submarines. It landed in the East Sea, also known as the Sea of Japan. Local media have reported that the North may have tested a submarine-launched missile, just weeks after South Korea unveiled its own such weapon, but this has not been confirmed by any officials. Japan's Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said there were two ballistic missiles fired, calling the launches very regrettable. Arms race. The launch comes as South Korea develops its own weapons, in what observers say has turned into an arms race on the Korean peninsula. Seoul is holding what is said to be South Korea's largest defense exhibition ever this week. It will reportedly unveil a new fighter jet as well as guided weapons like missiles. It is also due to launch its own space rocket soon. North and South Korea technically remain at war as the Korean War, which split the peninsula into two countries and which saw the US backing the South, ended in 1953 with an armistice. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un said last week that he did not wish for war to break out on the Korean peninsula again, but said his country needed to continue developing weapons for self-defense against enemies, namely the US, which he accused of hostility. The US envoy to North Korea, Sung Kim, is currently on his way to South Korea to discuss how to restart dialogue with Pyongyang, including on whether there should be a formal declaration of the end of the Korean War. In the last 24 hours, he has reiterated the stance of the Biden administration that it is open to meeting with North Korea without preconditions. Previous talks between the US and North Korea broke down due to fundamental disagreements on denuclearization. The US wants North Korea to give up its nuclear weapons before sanctions can be eased, but North Korea has so far refused.